Hi friends, today I am going to discuss about code division multiple access. We will see how this is implemented. So here I took one scenario that these are the stations, station 1, 2, 3, 4, and these stations are communicating using only common link. That means all these stations are connected through one link only. So by using this link only, they are able to transmit the data and they are able to communicate with each other. Okay. So now, few notations that we have to understand here. So this is the station, station 1, station 2, station 3 and station 4. Okay, this station will be sending, the first station will be sending data D1, second station data is D2, like that D3 and D4, and before sending through channel, this station 1 has to multiply its data using its own code, that is C1. So this is C1 and the station 1's code is C1, like that station 2's code is C2 and C3 and C4 as well. Now this is C1, C2, C3, C4, also called as chip sequences, and this sequence, like this is the coding actually, this is also called orthogonal sequence. What is this orthogonal sequence? Okay, so the speciality of orthogonal sequence is, if you multiply C1 with C2, you will get 0. C1 with any other one, like if you multiply any code with other code, you will get 0. For example, I am taking this, for example, I am taking C1 and C2, I will multiply both. Plus 1 into plus 1, plus 1. Plus 1 into minus 1, minus 1. Plus 1 into plus 1, plus 1. Plus 1 into minus 1, minus 1. So if I add this, what happens is, you will get 0. And if you multiply the same code, assume that C1 or C2, C3, any type. So for example, I am taking C3. This one is C1 into C2. You will get 0. Now I am taking C3 into C3. What happens is, plus 1 into plus 1, plus 1. Plus 1 into plus 1, again plus 1. Plus minus 1 into minus 1, plus 1. Minus into minus 1, plus 1. So what you got is plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, that equal to plus 4. Okay, so that means if you multiply with the same code, you will get 4. And if you multiply with any other code, then you will get 0. So this is actually a very important logic. So by using this only, this entire communication is going to be successful. Okay. So now, what we are doing is that those are the chip sequences, also called as orthogonal sequence that I explained. Now data representation. So data representations says that if any station wants to use, when they are sending, they may have the data like in terms of zeros and ones, but here we are representing 0 as minus 1 and 1 as plus 1, and if it is 0, that means that station is silent, that means it is not going to send any data. Okay, otherwise it is not going to put any data onto the channel. Okay, so now, so this is the scenario. Now the thing is that this channel contains some of all these datas, D1 C1 plus D2 C2 plus D3 C3 plus D4 C4. Now assume that if any station wants to receive the data, assume that station 4 I am taking, if station 4 wants to receive data from station 1, then what it has to do is, it has to multiply this entire data with station 1's code. Okay, what is station 1's code? Plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, plus 1. So if you multiply this entire data with C1, then what you will get is C1's data you will receive, means station 1's data you will receive. Okay, I will be explaining here now soon. Okay, so what I done here is, I took one example, that is D1's data is 1, D2's data is 0, D3 is 1, D4 is 1. Okay, that means D1 wants to send data as 1, D2, 0, D3, 1, D4, 1. So, according to this representations, data representation, if it is 0, we have to make it as minus 1. That means here it will become minus 1. 1 means plus 1. And this one also plus 1. And this also plus 1. Okay. So that's why I meant as D1, 1 means plus 1. 0 means minus 1. 1 means plus 1. Plus 1. Okay. Now, assume that all stations are putting their data onto the channel. Okay. For communication. So thing is that, see D1, D2. So, now station 1's, you know, put the data onto the channel as D1 multiplying its data with code 1. So D1, C1. What is D1? D1 is plus 1. This D1 is plus 1 and this is entire is C1. Okay, if you multiply this, plus 1 into plus 1, plus 1. Again, plus 1 into plus 1, plus 1. Plus 1 into plus 1, plus 1. Plus 1 into plus 1, plus 1. Okay, in the same way, D2, C2. D2 is what? Minus 1. Minus 1 into plus 1, minus 1, minus 1 into minus 1, plus 1, minus 1 into plus 1, minus 1, minus 1 into minus 1, plus 1. Okay, so D3, C3 and D4, C4. Okay, so I calculated here, multiplication of D1, all these things I wrote here. Now, sum of all these I wrote here. This is, as if that this is the common channel. So that's plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, minus 1, minus 1, like this. D1, C1, this one. D2, C2 is this one, D3, C3 is this one, D4, C4 is this one. Okay, now at the receiving end, Okay, now if any station, assume that D3, like station 3 or station 4 or station 2 or station 1, whatever it take. So if any station wants to receive any other station's data, assume that if I want to receive station 2's data, what is station 2's data equal, that is 0. So what I will get? Minus 1. Okay, assume that now station 3 wants to receive the station 2's data, then what it does is, what station 3 does, whatever the data is there, it will be multiplying with the station 2's code. What is station 2's code? Okay, station 2's code is plus 1, minus 1, plus 1, minus 1. Plus 1, minus 1, plus 1, minus 1. Okay. So, I am writing here. This place is not sufficient. Plus 1, minus 1, plus 1, minus 1. Okay. Now, I want to receive station 2's data. See, what is happening here. Plus 1 into plus 1, plus 1. And I have to add all these things. Okay. Plus 1. Okay. And plus. Plus into anything is plus into minus, minus only, so directly I am writing. So plus 1 into plus 1, plus 1. Plus 1 into minus 1, minus 1. Again plus 1 into plus 1, plus 1. And plus 1 into minus 1, minus 1. Okay, again plus. Minus 1 into plus 1, minus 1. Plus 1 into minus 1, minus 1. Minus 1 into plus 1, minus 1. Plus 1 into minus 1, minus 1. Then again this one. Now plus 1 into plus 1, plus 1. Plus 1 into minus 1, minus 1. Minus 1 into plus 1, minus 1. Minus 1 into plus 1, plus 1. Then again plus 1 into plus 1, plus 1. Minus 1 into minus 1, plus 1. Minus into plus 1, minus 1. And minus plus 1 into minus 1, minus 1. Okay. So now, plus 1, minus 1, plus 1, minus 1, cancel. Minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, see. Plus 1, minus 1. Again, minus 1, plus 1, plus 1, minus 1, plus 1, minus 1. What we got? minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. That means minus 4. So we got minus 4. The thing is that we have to divide this minus 4 by 4. Minus 4 by 4 to get the actual value. So why we are dividing by 4 means there are 4 stations. That's why we have to divide by 4. Okay. So what we got is minus 1. So what is minus 1 actually? Minus 1 is representation for 0. Minus 1 is represented for 0. So now we got station 2's data. What is station 2's data? That is 0. Okay. So in this way we are going to get the data. Assume that if I want station 1's data, what you do is in place of this, you write plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, plus 1. Then what you will get is, you will get 1. That is station 1's data. If you want to receive station 3's data, then what you have to do is, you have to multiply with the station 3's code. Okay. So by using this code, you will get, if you multiply this entire channel data with code, with this station 3's code, you will receive station 3's data. Okay. In this way, it is going to be, you know, happening.